So, boys, first one was the new Twilight. Second one, one of the most successful films of 2013. Critical acclaim, box office success. Is there pressure now you're reaching the home straight, or you feel fine? Apart from being sick, of course, Josh.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for caring.
I'm so concerned.
I don't think, I mean, for me, it's not really a pressure. The pressure for me on set is always just to make a good movie and like to, you know, try to do my part. As far as like if people see it and if it does well and everything, that's kind of out of our control. I think our job is to make a good movie and to give a good performance. So that's kind of where I've always focused my energy and my nervousness, so to speak.
Do you take any notice of reviews?
I don't. I don't read any reviews or pictures or
No, because I mean, if you start doing that, you can read 100 good ones and one bad one, and you're only going to remember the bad one.
So
there's no point.
Is Mockingjay the movie you've kind of been waiting to make? Because ironically, sort of without The Hunger Games, it opens up a lot more and it becomes a bigger film. Certainly for you, Liam.
Yeah, for me, definitely. I've got a lot more to do on this one. I was very excited to shoot this one and had a lot more to play with, a much different dynamic with Katniss. A lot more physical things. Different locations in these ones, which is great.
You've got a different dynamic with Katniss, aka you've got more than like three scenes with her now.
Yeah.
Josh, what are you up to? Like, you spent the first two movies with Jen Lawrence, and now you're just on your
own. That's right.
Did you miss her on set?
I missed her so much. Missed the whole crew, man. Like I knew, like in Mockingjay 1, I'm captured in the Capitol for a lot of it, and so I'm not really. Wasn't really part of the filming a lot for that first film, and that was sad, man. Like to be at home knowing that my best friends were out making this movie, and I was stuck in my own bed with my dog, which was nice. But
sounds awful.
Yeah.
But you were stuck in your bed with your dog.
Yes.
But you weren't starving yourself, were you?
I wasn't.
Because I've just come back from speaking from Jake Gyllenhaal, Nightcrawler. If you've seen it,
loses
30 pounds, dedicated method actor. You just relied on CGI, is that
That's
right?
That's absolutely right.
Yeah.
I'm not healthier. To his level yet. I'm working
it's much
on
healthier.
It. Yeah, much healthier. It's true, yeah. Much healthier.
But it must have been fun to be proper, all messed up, crazy.
Yeah, no, I was looking forward to Mockingjay, because I love the book, and that's kind of the moment when PETA really turns, and you know, he goes from being this guy that everybody knows him as, and gets tortured and brainwashed and everything, and so his kind of descent into that was something I was really excited to sort of take on and had a really good time doing it.
This is all over for you. You've finished filming, haven't you? I mean, is this weird coming back to sort of talking about this?
I have nothing else to live for. I'm done, man.
In your bed every day.
Game over, man.
Getting sick.
We didn't finish that long ago, so it feels like it's just been one long over a year now. I mean, we were shooting this time last year, and then we finished a few months ago. So it's hasn't been that big of a break between.
But it's weird not knowing there's another one, like, for me, like thinking that we're not going to film another one. It's kind of strange.
So the tears aren't welling up just yet, but this time next year.
I cry every night.
Yeah.
I cry every single night and sometimes mornings as well.
Double cry. Yeah. And yet your dog's wondering what the hell's going on with you, just weeping into your pillow every night.
Yeah, he gets it.
Okay, good.
Yeah. He's connected.
Pleasure, thank you.
Take care.